Hi, and welcome to Spice and Pans. Today we'll be cooking braised beef noodles or 红烧牛肉面. So let's start cooking. We are now going to fry the aromatics using our multi cooker. I'm using open lid mode or open cover mode. Heat up the pot, add in a little bit of oil. Just a little bit will do. Put in approximately 2 thumb size of ginger slice. I'm using young ginger, this is approximately 30 grams. Separate them out so that the oil is in contact with the ginger. Add in one whole bulb of garlic, peeled. Three pieces of shallots, chopped. I will also add in one piece of cinnamon stick as well as one star anise. We'll fry until we can smell the beautiful fragrance from the ingredients. I'm beginning to smell the beautiful fragrance. Add in 20 grams of rock sugar. We need to melt this and caramelize this. This will take a little while. This is a very easy to cook meal. You just need to prepare this in the morning and in the afternoon for lunch. You just need to blanch some vegetables as well as your noodles. Pour the gravy over it and you have your lunch. Very simple and delicious. The reason why we want to caramelize the sugar is because we want the beef shin to have a very beautiful color. When the sugar has caramelized, we add in 500 grams of beef shin, cut into pieces like this. Not too small because it will shrink. Mix them up well. Brown them for a little while. Don't take beef, you can replace it with chicken or with pork, no problem. Of course, the cooking timing is slightly different, but they taste delicious as well. I'm using beef shin over here, but of course you can use brisket or any part of a cow. Beef flank, for example, no problem. Depends on what you want for your favorite cut. When they have started to brown, we'll add in 3 tablespoons of dark soy sauce. Mix them up well. Now we'll add in 3 tablespoons of light soy sauce. Mix them up well too. I'll add in now 1/2 tablespoon of spicy broad bean paste. Stir it up. Wow, smells really, really good. Add in 2 pieces of bay leaves. 2 stalks of spring onion tied in a knot. Mix them up a little bit. I'll be also adding in 1/2 tablespoon of Sichuan peppercorn. Put into a small container like this. And 1 tablespoon of white peppercorn. Same thing. Close it up. Put it in. Add in 400 grams of daikon or radish. Cut into size like this. Nothing too thin. Just spread them out on top. Now add in 1 liter of water. Mix them up. Now we just need to pressure cook this. Put the lid on, lock it. I'm going to turn this multi-cooker into a pressure cooking pot now. Switch to bean or meat. And then I like the flavor a little bit more intense, so I put under reach. 35 minutes and I'll see you back in a while. The beef is done already. If you are using a pressure cooker like me, remember to release the steam first before you open up the lid. Let's open up and take a look inside. Wow, smells really, really good. Let's just give this a taste first before deciding how much of a salt to put in. Wow. Very flavorful. I'll turn it to open lid cooking because I'll need to add in the salt as well as thicken the sauce up. I'm just going to add in 2 teaspoons of salt. This should be good enough for this. You can always adjust the amount of salt to your preference. Now I'd like to remove everything from the pot before I thicken up the sauce. So using a strainer, we'll slowly remove everything. Once the sauce has come to a boil, we will add in cornstarch solution to thicken it up. thicken it up to the consistency that you like. This is how I like it to be, a little bit thick so that it can coat our noodles very well. Now we'll proceed to blanch our vegetables as well as cook our noodles. Now we'll blanch our vegetables. Boil a pot or pan of water, add in just a little bit of salt, a little bit of oil. Add in a bunch of your favorite greens. I'm using garlic over here. The reason I'm putting oil and salt inside there is that after you blanch it, it will be glistening and the green will remain very green. Just blanch them for a little short while. If you like it crunchier, you can just take it out after maybe like 10-20 seconds. If you like it softer, then of course you can boil it slightly longer. Okay, I like it a little bit crunchy, so I think this is done. I'll just remove this from the heat. I'll be using this as a garnish as well as to make the meal complete. I'll be using the same water to boil my noodles. I'm using regular Chinese ramen or Chinese dried noodles. Just put it in. If you want, you can also change the water. It's really up to you, individual preferences. You boil them until soft or al dente, depending on how you like your noodles to be. After this is done, just drain the noodles, pour the gravy over it, add in the beef as well as the daikon and vegetables, and you will have your lunch. Well, of course, you can use any noodles you want. You can use glass vermicelli, or even those mee kia, mee pok, whatever noodles that you want to use, no problem at all. Or even rice. The gravy on top of rice is also very good, but I love noodles, so yep, I'm cooking noodles now. Okay, I'm about done. So I'll drain the noodles and I will serve our lunch. And now the dish is done, let's have a taste. Oh, smells really, really very nice. Mmm. The gravy is very nice beefy taste. Let's try the beef. Super tender. You can just use your tongue and push the meat to the top of your jaw and it will just disintegrate. It is just that tender, very, very nice. So ladies and gentlemen, this is how we cook our braised beef noodles. I hope you like our video. Do click like on our video and do subscribe to our channel. Thank you for watching.